All right, guys, we are here live with Shanu Anu at the Vixen headquarters. This is very exciting for me because
welcome.
You know, it's awesome that we're gonna be going down a series and something that I've always seen, and finally we're here talking is like when women take it to the next level and hustle their butts off, do many projects, good deeds out there, and it's somebody that we may not have a long history of friendship, but it's always admiring somebody else's business, their hustle, their grind. So welcome and thank you for joining us.
Thank you so much for having me. I'm excited to talk. I'm excited for this conversation, so thanks so much for having me, and I'm excited to talk to everybody out there.
Well, everybody's excited. We've had a lot of individuals talk about, hey, you know, we're excited that you're doing this. We had a lot of friends and reaching out saying, oh my God, that's my bestie, she's awesome. We're gonna talk about, you know, her struggles and becoming, you know, an entrepreneur. We're gonna talk about the history. We're gonna talk about the Vixen Army. We're gonna talk about other projects she's done. We're gonna talk about little things that she hasn't shared with anybody, but she's gonna share with us for the first time. We're gonna talk about some random facts. We're gonna put some questions that I didn't even tell her about, but not some crazy questions, but some things that I don't want to keep it too much script. But so we're gonna ask her. So a little bit of yourself, where you came from, your upbringing, how you're here today, how everything that you're doing for, you know, for yourself and, you know, so many individuals that follow you. How did that all come about? Give us a history of yourself.
So, first and foremost, I'm from Miami.
Okay.
I'm born and raised in Miami, Little Havana to be exact.
Ooh, okay.
Little Havana, Shenandoah, and the Rose. That was like my stomping grounds growing up.
Okay.
So, my background is I actually, everything kind of starts for me after high school.
Okay.
With Vixen and with dancing, that was kind of something that was a part of my life since I was small.
Gotcha.
Dancing since I was 3 years old, it's always been a passion. So Vixen, to kind of give you a history on Vixen, it began from the founder, Janet Jones, her space in her life where she was in a very dark space, a very dark place. She had started working in a corporate job after being an international dancer, traveling throughout the world with like Pitbull, J-Lo, all of that type of thing. And then she started working a corporate job. She started living outside of her truth. She started living outside of what makes her happy. She was extremely unhappy. The Vixen Workout was born. She had a studio. She started dancing in a room. Little by little, girls started coming to class, started coming to what used to be called Video Vixen, because it's like modeling, like if you are a dancer or a performer. And then the Vixen Workout was born. Where I come into this picture is I actually saw one of my good friends post about the Vixen Workout on Instagram, and I saw that they were dancing to hip hop in heels. And I was like, wait a minute, hip hop, heels, I need to go to this class. So at that point I was really small, there was a couple of girls in the class, and the minute that I walked into the room at Vixen, I immediately felt like the void that I had had from years of not dancing after high school fulfilled. And it was incredible. That was 5 years ago now, and it's been a constant in my life since. And the most amazing part of the Vixen Workout, which is, it's not only the dancing aspect and the workout aspect, it's the philosophy behind it and what we stand for and the message that we share, which is that everybody has a light. Everybody has a light, every woman has a light. Sometimes we were stomped by life and we go through downs and we go through ups and we go through downs, but everybody has that. So the message is just finding that light, not getting lost in the rubble. If you have a bad moment in life, if you have a struggle, we've all had them, I've had them, everybody has, is just remember that light within yourself so that you can come out of it. The Vixen Workout is a community that encourages that. And we tell the women, come here, dance your heart out. It doesn't matter if you can dance, if you have dance experience, it's a place to let loose, be yourself, and just come back to your life. So that's our message at the Vixen Workout.
I love it, and it's one of those things that, you know, normally when I'm talking, it's like your passion is there. Normally, you know, I've done these, you know, interviews or I talk to somebody about their training. I can see the passion you have for this. like you, it's spewing from
you. Yes, it's a huge passion of mine. I love it. It's something I'm grateful for, Vixen. I swear to you, I am.
And you know, and that's one of the things that, you know, I noticed as, you know, not knowing, you know, what this was, or many years ago, I would see it, and it always caught my eye, you know, because you guys do a great job on the social media aspect. The community aspect of it, which, you know, when you're saying about empowering and being there whenever you're going through something, it's always good to be in community, a fellowship,
absolutely.
Right?
Absolutely.
And that's something I always noticed without even knowing of you or Vixen. I was like, man, that's something pretty cool. And the hip hop part, like, man, it's
the cat. It's like you turned into Beyonce. It's like you've always wanted to be Beyonce. This is the place to come be it. So it's cool.
So that definitely, and I want to make sure it's on the vlog camera here. Boom. All right. So
we're on? Okay.
Yeah, no, we're on. I just want to make sure it was angled right. Since this is a one-man production on this vlog. So what one of the questions that I had asked you, and you mentioned it a little bit, what does it mean? Because you have the Vixen thing, but you do other things. How has this helped you? What does this help with your persona, your business? How has this helped you? Or also with viewers, how does this help them out there in the real world when you get out of here? Because when you guys see it, and we're gonna do something cool, I'm gonna show you this, because normally we leave the camera stand, but this place is so cool, you guys gotta see it. But
we're gonna do a tour.
how does this help you when you go back out there in the real world? How has it helped your business? How has this right here helped you?
So it's helped me in ways that I feel I could write a book about. But to tell you right now, it has taken me from a little girl to being a woman. And I mean that in my self-confidence. I mean that in understanding that you can do things that you're passionate about and incorporate that into your life.
Gotcha.
And incorporate that in not just, for example, an hour of me dancing here. That's what it taught me as before I became an instructor. I walked into this room. I was in a weird place in my life. It was right after college. I was an assistant to a real estate broker at the time, before I got my real estate license. So I was kind of in a weird place where I was trying to figure out, what am I gonna do? I'm 22, 23 years old. I need to kind of get a move on. I wasn't necessarily the most happy with my job at that moment.
Gotcha.
After I met Vixen and after I started being a student and instructing, I gained this confidence. The happiness that I felt in that dance room and in dancing and in being in community with the people that I was in community with, it gave me the confidence to say, if I'm not happy with something, I need to make a change. I need to step outside of the comfort zone. I need to find what I feel in this moment for this hour outside of this room. And that's where Vixen and my life kind of merge and fuse. It's a philosophy that tells you, you don't need to settle for less. You know, you can do what you're passionate about. So another thing is, when we're in that dance room and we're dancing, you feel alive. You feel alive. Many people have never felt that. You know, because you're just in the rat race, you're doing what you need to do, you're going to school, you're doing work. You don't have a moment in our society. Thankfully now it's changing in that aspect, but 5 years ago, our society, and more years ago, our society did not encourage or embrace stop and feel. What do you feel? Are you happy with what you're doing? So in the hour of being inside of Vixen, you feel alive. It's incredible. You don't have to have previous dance experience to be like, wow, I feel so great. So it's taking that feeling that for the first time, and taking that outside. And applying that to your life so that you can feel alive all the time. So that you can do things with courage and with passion and believing in yourself. So
I love, and I'm thinking, just like anything community-wise, and you know, when you're able to, and I'm sure like when you get in here, you're speaking to a lot more people than you normally would in your workplace. It helps your confidence, networking abilities, guys. You always got to do something with the networking side of things, where you could get a potential client here, I'm guessing.
I have.
So, you know, and not only that, you know, you're seeing all types of walks of life, I'm guessing, walking in here.
Yes.
Is there, what are the requirements? What is the ages? I'm sure you welcome many. Like, what is the, your requirements to come to?
So your requirements to come, for the most part, is you have to be a woman.
Okay. Oh man, guys, well, you know, when is Vixen Men Army starting, right?
I will say we have had co-ed, we call it like Diva Nights, have co-ed classes, but for the most part, it's woman-based. We welcome everybody.
Okay.
We welcome absolutely everyone. I've had people as young as 16 or 15 and as old as 72 in a class. Because the soul never stops. You're young, you're old, but you always have a soul. Everybody always wants to feel alive. So we welcome absolutely everybody. Everybody's welcome.
Okay, I love it. As you became an instructor, you know, in case if there's any instructors out there or inspiring instructors, not only in dance or, you know, any kind of in the gym world and the athletic world, what roadblocks did you encounter coming through it? Like what was the hard times? What did you do that you wouldn't change? Give us some examples of that.
So at the beginning, I think that my roadblock to start was that I might've been a little bit conscious about the fact that I didn't have professional experience dancing on a stage with performers or being on tour. My passion for dance was kind of just something that was innate. So at the beginning, I was kind of like, well, when Janet asked me if I wanted to be an instructor, I was like, I can't be an instructor. I'm not you. Like I can't do what you do. You know, I've never been on a stage dancing in front of 50,000 people.
Gotcha.
And so that kind of played a toll at the beginning. But the amazing thing is that she reiterated it to me, and we reiterate this to future instructors and aspiring instructors, is that you don't need to fit inside of a box.
Gotcha.
You don't need to fit inside of a box of previous professional dancer. You can just love to dance.
Gotcha.
Be open to dance, be personable, be approachable, be somebody that is there with your people, with your students. We don't teach a class and it's kind of like I'm the teacher and you're the student. It's kind of like this is a community. You guys are following me. Feel free to break out into solos if you have to. It's a very open, flowing. And
so I would say boost your self-confidence. Being if you're like timid,
yes,
I'm sure he or breaks you out.
It breaks you out, and then not only breaks you out inside the dance room, it really breaks you out in life,
guys,
to say the least.
That's so. Win-win whenever you could get, you know, that. Especially a lot of people are scared to even approach anybody. Spark a conversation with someone. Actually, so definitely,
it
know,
helps.
I would check
it
that out.
Definitely helps.
All right, so we got that. Okay, so talk to us. You know, as an entrepreneur doing having many hats, and we were talking about this earlier, like where a lot of people would say, hey, you're doing too much.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm against, I am on firm on the fact that if you're working 20, 30 hours a week, and you shouldn't do too many things, you should be a master of one thing. But if you're working your butt off, you could do many hats, especially when they associate to each other. What are the other hats you wear? What are the other businesses that you entail? Being a boss person, what other businesses do you have your hands on?
So, Vixen's number one, of course, or what we're talking about right now.
Okay.
I'm a real estate agent, of course, and I've been.
How long have you been doing that?
I've been involved in the real estate industry for 10 years.
Okay.
So right out of high school, I became an assistant to a residential broker, and then after that to a commercial broker. Right, I would say maybe like 6 years before I got my license. In 2012.
Okay.
So real estate is another huge passion of mine. The other thing that I'm involved with right now, I have two projects that I'm working on that I'm very proud of and very excited about. So I'm excited to talk to you about it today. Is I have a passion as well for social media, interacting and connecting with people.
Gotcha.
It's something that I've incorporated in with my own, say, promotion for Vixen and my promotion for real estate.
Gotcha.
It was always kind of something that like I was drawn to, the marketing aspect, the social media aspect. So with Life Colors, which is a Miami-based advertisement company and marketing, who has been print-based for the most part, we're developing a social media division, which is it's going to take care of anything you can imagine for digital marketing.
Gotcha.
Social media management, content creation, anything that you can imagine for the digital aspect of any business, we're handling. So I'm excited to be a part of the development of that division at Life Colors. I can give you more information about that later. That's all.
And I'm gonna link it. I'm gonna, you know, Alicia News, a cell phone number, we'll put her social media. And just to speak on that, like, I'm here today and we're doing this interview because you've had such a good social media presence. And, you know, the businesses that I've opened and run, it's heavy social media.
Heavy.
So that's the number one tool. Like, if people ask you, what's the secret sauce? Of course, having a good foundation, having good beliefs, running a good business, but the marketing aspect, social media has been number
Absolutely.
One, and that is king. It's free.
It's free. And the thing is that it might not come easy to many people. Another thing is when you're running a business, there are some people that can wear many hats at the same time, as you were saying. And if you have a knack for it and you kind of like it, it's fun.
No.
Some people are so busy running their business and running, you know, numbers, that aspect of a business, that they might not have time for social media.
No.
So people that enjoy it, like me, will come in and will help and develop, you know, programs. So that's one of them. The other thing I'm extremely excited to talk about, sorry, is a blog that I'm launching. It's called Live Play Miami. This has been a dream for 3 years now, which sometimes things get in the way, but I believe that God has perfect timing for everything.
Amen.
And so this is the timing for me with this. It's a blog based on Miami, of course. The categories that I'll kind of be talking about and touching on will be Miami real estate, Miami culture, and Miami spirituality.
Gotcha.
Those three things are what make up my life right now. The culture, the booming culture that we have in Miami right now. Of course, real estate, because that's what I've been involved with for so long. Another huge passion, like I said. And then spirituality, which is number one for me and kind of what keeps the wheels going for me. So I'm excited to kind of share my perspective and kind of from my life, what's kind of helped me, what's hindered, the roadblocks that I've had, and then kind of tie that in with the fun culture that we have in Miami.
I love
it. So that's coming soon.
That was the exciting part I wanted, because that's always something, you know, that's big to me too. And, you know, and when we were talking about the different hats, whenever you could do multiple hats and do it well, if it's something that is associated, if you're here networking around people buy houses, people do different types, people need marketing and whatever type of business. If you're gonna do a blog of all of that incorporated, it's kind of like putting all of it together and documenting it. That, and when you guys ask questions or you're viewing this, this is what it does. It keeps it circulating, keeps you current. So if you guys are inspiring to grow your business or grow yourselves or be entertained or do something fun, I'm telling you, do it. Go out of your way.
It's an outlet.
It's an outlet.
Absolutely an outlet when you can kind of bring in what you do for a living and the fun aspect.
No.
It's fun to create. It's fun to go out there and check places out and do whatever makes you feel good.
Great.
So that's the excitement and the motivation behind my blog, which I'm excited. This is the first time I talk about it publicly. So
you should have seen yesterday. Yesterday we were talking about the show. Okay, this, she wrote like paragraphs on text. Like, hey, I want to talk about this. And I'm making light of it and funny, but it was passion based. So it was like, you know, like you had to scroll. You had to scroll. So that was cool. So that was excited. And that was one of the key points I wanted to bring up, because I saw the passion behind it. So I'm excited for that.
Yeah.
Please, when do you have a timeline?
Mid-April.
Mid-April?
It's pretty much ready to go. Just a little final touches here and there. And I will be launching it in mid-April.
Okay. So guys, we'll put that in. You know, I'm sure she'll announce it after this. You guys can follow her and, you know, her social media links, so you can see when she announces it. Let's do some random facts. Last book you read?
Well, the book I'm reading right now is called The Gifts of Imperfection by Brené Brown. I'm so excited you asked me about that, because I'm obsessed with this book right now.
Okay.
I'm halfway through it and it is just shining so much light on me right now. So that's a book I'm reading. I totally suggest it 100%.
Okay. We'll put it in the comments. And one of the things that, well, she had asked me today, because, you know, avid readers. She was like, hey, you know, I told about a book I'm reading, guys. It's 10% happier. Because you have a class here that you're starting yoga
yes,
here, right?
Yes, it's called Hip Hop Flow.
Oh,
Hip Hop Yoga. So we incorporate yoga and hip hop, Biggie, Tupac, all that good
okay.
stuff.
Okay. So if Eileen's tuning in here and she's seeing this, she's probably like intrigued. So she has to come over.
You gotta come,
here.
Girl. You gotta come.
And when's your class? Your next class?
My classes are Wednesday at 7 p.m.
Okay.
Fridays, the happy hour at 6:30 p.m. So
okay.
we call it a happy hour because it's the best happy hour in Miami.
All right. And so we'll put the link. So you guys should come see her tomorrow or
yes,
for happy
tomorrow.
Hour Friday.
Mm-hmm.
So check that out. Okay, let's see. I got this one. If you were going to put a billboard in the street, like you had one billboard on the side of Miami and you wanted to put something empowering or something you're like big on and you wanted to share with the world, now you gotta think, and I'm giving you time to think,
mm-hmm.
what would you share with the world? What message would you put on that billboard for the world to see?
Your light lies within, shine it bright. That would be my message.
Hey, listen.
Your light lies within. Shine it bright.
This wasn't scripted. That's good. That's something, you know, sometimes people need that reminder. Mm-hmm. That's why, like, you know, I was sharing earlier that I've been trying this meditation thing. Before I would just pray, and that was something, and I'll pray, you know, 2-3 minutes and move on, and it's tough to meditate.
It is.
10 minutes seems like an hour, especially where I'm at and I'm incorporating. That's like my biggest task or project and organ is the meditation thing. And I'm telling you, in those little minutes, I mean, outside of my 5-minute journal that I've shared with you guys that I do, and the prayers I do at night right before, and then in the morning being grateful for the day, meditation is tough. And being that light and sharing is so important because you'll lose track of your day. And this is a quote. This is the quote I'll put now that I think about it. They say, and you could plug in whatever you want here, spirituality, God, and I'll say, he who runs from God in the morning is scarce to find them throughout the day. So sometimes
that's deep.
You think about it, the days that I don't stop in the morning, become grateful, or review what I have to do and slow everything down, that's the craziest day. I get home and I'm like, man, today.
You're like, where did my day go? Absolutely. And we were talking about that. That's part of my life right now as well. And just to kind of add on to that, they say that when you pray, you're talking to God, and when you meditate, God is talking to you. So
okay.
That's a good outlet.
Look, and it's funny, and I was sharing it. It just happens to be, you know, the last people that have been on the blog, you know, that's big in their lives, and that's big in my life. But it's never something that I go out and search for it, and it happens to be that somebody is spiritual, and that's great. And this is catered to everybody. But sometimes you might be the light in a dark place where you may be in your life, and just you sharing or your message could spark somebody, and that sparks other people. So
absolutely.
that's the beauty of these things. That's why
absolutely.
She was asking me about the blog thing. Why I do it, and we shared and we kind of agreed. It's just like helping others, man, to find it.
Connecting.
When you die and you move from this world, all the money, all the cars, the houses, they don't come with you, but your spiritual bank account goes with you. So you gotta make sure you put some deposits in that.
Your legacy.
Yeah.
Your legacy of how you helped people and what difference you made.
No.
For me, that's really important. I do have my hands in a couple of things that make me happy here, but if I don't have my spiritual alignment and connection with God and that relationship, I am out of whack. And I've lived in those places, and it's a extreme perfect correlation between living peacefully, and we're gonna have tribulations, we're gonna have hard moments, but when you have kind of like that foundation and you could say, okay, well, all of this crazy stuff is happening around me, but I can kind of come back to the center and know that something out there is taking care of me and is looking out after me, that's a huge sense of comfort and relief, and that's kind of that pushes me every single day.
All right, I mean, guys, this is you know, I'm gonna check if we've got any questions here, but that was deep. We've have let's see questions up in here. Okay, so let me I'm on the laptop Facebook Live, but
we have so many cameras.
We got so many cameras. We have three phones, a laptop.
Yeah.
So something you guys on Facebook Live are not gonna see, which we're gonna do now, but you'll be able to see it on the YouTube video, is we're gonna take a tour of the actual Vixen building.
Their studio.
And guys, I wanna thank you so much. Sanu, thank you so much for taking the time.
Thank you so much.
Tune in, I'm gonna put her Instagram, come to her class, follow her business, do your social media with her, buy real estate from her.
Yes.
So rock and roll, guys. Thank you so much
for tuning in.
Take care, guys.
Thank you, bye guys.
This is the behind the scenes. This is the continuation of our blog that we just had. So let's get the tour. Let's show it to us.
So welcome to the studio. This is our kind of lobby area. This is where you check in before a class, and where you kind of get your information from for next classes, that type of thing. Over here we have our office.
Mm-hmm.
You'll notice there's a lot of pink and a lot of beautiful because we believe in pink. We believe in pink, and this is actually a message, if you can get that.
Mm-hmm.
It says, damn, you look good.
There you go.
Important. So as you come through the center of the studio, right here we have our merch area, which is kind of like our little boutique where we drop our latest lines. You can follow VXN Apparel if you want to see more of that. This is our behind the scenes, or the stage, where you would do your makeup, that type of thing, before you go into class.
Uh-huh.
This is another little waiting area right here.
Uh-huh.
We have our bathrooms. This is our visionary wall that says everything kind of that we stand for and that we love. And then this is where the magic happens.
Uh-huh.
This is our studio and our dance room. So you can take a look inside. It's a little bit dark, but this is where the classes happen. This is where all the women come to dance every single day, pretty much Monday through Sunday. So
I love it.
Yes.
This is awesome.
Yes. We have classes all week long. We have certifications coming up on April 14th, and I teach Wednesdays at 7 p.m. and Fridays at 6:30 p.m. So
all right.
Come on down.
All right, thank you.